Hi, welcome to an Inventor 2017 video tutorial. I want to model the coupling with Draft now in Inventor, and I use the same picture as before, and it went very smoothly in Inventor. So let's have fun with Inventor. Let's start with the reference planes, so I will just make them visible. And I need one plane with a distance from the YZ plane, and this should be 205. I need another one millimeter above that plane, and one with 1 millimeter below the exit plane. Then I need one with a distance of 60 from the exit plane, and again one with 1 millimeter above that plane, and one with 1 millimeter below that plane. Minus one. Okay, now I can do my first sketch, which would be on that XY plane. And I need some elements for reference, so we'll make them for construction. That would be this plane and that plane. Now I need a line which runs from that point horizontal up and right over there. Maybe let's hide this plane. And this should be for construction, that's okay, but the next should be standard. So this point should be coincident to that projected plane. And that line should be collinear to this one. Two dimensions. This would be 42.4, and this might be 46.7. Then add some more lines. Close. No, I'm sorry. Okay. Now this should be horizontal, yes. And that point right here should be on the midpoint. And that point should be on that midpoint. Then these two points should be aligned vertical and to this one. And here the same. And two dimensions. This should be 30. And this should be 16. It's fully constrained. Finish the sketch. Now make an extrude, make it symmetric, make it 60 millimeters. Next sketch on the XZ plane. Cut the graphics, slice the graphics. That would be as, no. This should look something like, now close, okay, make that point to the midpoint coincident and add an angle over here, which would be 86, and another one right there, 86 as well, and project that geometry, make it for construction only, and this line should be collinear to that projection. Finish the sketch, and I forgot one dimension. That line should be 50. Finish the sketch. Now let's make an extrude with that sketch. Make it an intersection, and it should go in both directions through all. See, that's not possible, so make it a distance, make it asymmetric, doesn't matter. Maybe like this, go for 30 and 80, doesn't matter. And I got my first body. Now I could hide those planes for the moment. Okay, and this one as well. So I would need the sketch, the first sketch. I want to make a copy and paste it onto the same plane. Paste. Let's hide those bodies for the moment. And I need this plane. And this plane. And maybe that plane. Let's see. So that's okay, but this moves, so project, go into the sketch, not this one, but into this one, and okay, there should be the center point. But maybe I have to project it. Okay. Yeah, of course, the projection didn't go with the sketch and with the copy. Make it to the midpoint right here. This one should be coincident to that one, so I'll make a project geometry on this one. And this should be collinear, and another project geometry, this one, make it again for construction only, and this line should be right there, collinear. Okay, I only need these lines, not the other ones, so I will make them all for projection and then just select those three elements and make it standard, but not this one. Okay, I need select other, that's the curve, yes, and okay, finish the sketch. Now let's make an extrude, make it a surface, with that sketch right here. Distance symmetric. And that would be 60. And okay. Then I need two offset planes. First I should do the fillets. There should be a fillet 25 right here. Apply. And one with 18 over there. Okay, now I need a offset surface. Make it a surface, make it a quilt. 1 millimeter. Like this. Apply. And with the same one. No. I want to select the complete extrusion. That should be quilt surface. Okay, like this, and to the other direction, 1 millimeter, and okay. Now let's hide the original one, and I got those two surfaces. Let's show our body. Now I want to split that face and the other face with these two surfaces. So go for split. The first tool would be that surface, and the faces which should be split is one on this side and one on that side. Apply, and then with the second surface as tool, this face and that face. And okay, now I could hide those surfaces and yeah, that's sort of a bug. The edges should be visible. See? Now I got those edges. And then I can make the drafts. And already, once again. Okay. First I want to add the fillet. So go for fillet. 10 millimeters on that edge and this edge. Apply, then one with 40 millimeters over here. Apply, and one with 26 over there. And okay, now I can do my drafts, and I will use with the fixed edge option. And you have to take care where you select the face. If you select it more to this edge, it will draft differently to if you select it more to that edge. Okay, but first go to draft. It needs the pulling direction. That would be the y-axis in this case, the y-axis, and select it nearer to that edge, and I need 4 degrees. And it will draft like this. That's kind of odd because it should be removing this. So let's check. Let's try it once again. That's really kind of odd. 4 degrees. Sometimes the preview doesn't fit, but the pulling direction would be the y-axis once again, and select it here. Now really, it should be the other way around. Of course you could try -4. That doesn't work. And if you turn around the pull direction, it goes outside. That's kind of crazy. And my edges are not visible anymore. Great. Shaded with edges. Okay. Let's make it 4 degrees. The pulling direction would be the y-axis. And somehow it doesn't get that right. If you select it here, it will not work. You have to select it right here somewhere. Or you can try it here. And now it works. That's really kind of odd. But it's okay. And the same on the other side. So let's try it once again right here. Now it works on both sides. Yeah, maybe I just didn't recognize it. Sometimes that's kind of misleading. And apply it. And next would be the y-axis again, but the other way around. Now select it more on nearer to that edge, that face. Looks good. Same over here. Okay. Now let's add the fillets. That would be a fillet, variable radius, select that edge, and maybe, yeah, first you have to select the edge, and the radius, see, I clicked here and that's the start point, that's kind of odd, but okay. That would be 4, and this one would be 10, and I need 2 more points. So select start, move right here, that would be another 4 millimeter, and go back to the start, move right here, and that would be 10 millimeter, and apply. Then select that edge. So start would be 5 and would be 8. And then select that point and this point, that would be 5 and this would be 8. Apply, turn it around, same procedure over here. Let's select this edge and now that's the start point. That's really crazy. This would be 10 and would be 4. Click here, move to that point and to that point. This would be 10 and that would be 4. Apply. Now select this edge. Start. Is 5 and is 8. Then I need 2 more points, one here and one there. This would be 8 and that should be 5 and okay. And I got my first body and it's complete. Now I could hide it. And let's go for the other ones. I need that. I should maybe show the planes. And maybe the work planes as well. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, workplane 2, workplane 3, the center one, these should be visible as well. Okay. Now sketch on the XZ plane. This would be a circle. Diameter should be 50. Finish the sketch. Make an extrude. Make it symmetric. Make it 50. But this has to be a new body. And another sketch on that plane, another circle, diameter should be 30. Now let's project that plane, make it for construction only, and this one should be right there, and these two points should be horizontal aligned. Finish the sketch, make another extrude, make it symmetric, make it 30, and make it a new body. Confirm. Now I can do the drafts with fixed planes and asymmetric. So go for draft, 4 degrees is okay. Now go for this option. That's with fixed plane. And the fixed plane, let's do this one first, would be this one. And the faces which should be drafted, these. Now go for asymmetric. More, and change from absolute to relative. Otherwise you will get an error message. And the second angle should be 0. Apply, then the fixed plane is this one. Turn it around 180 degrees for yes. Again, that's okay, and apply. Now to this one, that's the first one, that's the second one, okay. That's the surface. Still 0 and relative, apply. Then that's work plane 3. Turn it around the direction, select the face, and again relative 0 and okay. Now I could hide the planes. I could do it with that tool. Hide the origin planes and hide the user work planes. Show the first body. And I want to add some fillets, 0.5 radius, and 1, 2, apply, 1, 2, apply, and 1, 2, turn it around, 1, no, not this one, but that one, and okay. Now let's combine these bodies. So go for combine, And let's say this is the base, one tool body, second tool body, and it should be a union. That's really odd. Always vanishing edges. Okay, now let's go for the next fillets. This would be 6. Right there, over there, and here. Apply. Next would be 4. Here, here, and there. And okay. Looks very good. Now the holes. So go for a hole. Make it concentric. Make it through all, that's okay. And that would be that surface and that edge as reference. And the diameter should be 30. Okay. And this face, that edge as reference, concentric. And diameter would be 18, I suppose. And okay. Now if you want, you can add a draft right here. And you can add the pocket right here. So I will leave it with this and maybe add the chamfers, 1 millimeter here, there, apply, and maybe one with 2.5 on that edge and this edge, and okay. And I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, give it a like, leave a comment, please subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.